But you know, Sandhawk might be their map. However, there's only one rotation every single time. Looks like the games are ready. Let's get into it. Back to Erangel, match two of the day.
Everybody has been waiting. Hopefully there's no three times of trolling.
Please.
I'm praying to God that it's going to be a smooth sailing. So everybody waiting for any bridge camping circle.
A bridge camping circle? I mean...
Oh, look at that. My path.
Okay.
Straight from the west side of the map there.
It's pretty... Not exactly the best. People who usually drop into Novo as well as Malta Power is going to have to travel a little bit. Again, Bigatron not going to worry too much as, you know, military base is still pretty accessible, as well as Team Secret, who wants to go into Pochinki. George Pol and Razok might be heavily contested, though.
Yeah, but talking about not needing to worry, we have our excellent observers there going to bring all the action to us from the ground onwards, ladies and gentlemen. So Milta Power is going to be very interesting. This is what's going to happen. What's going to happen to Bapa? So now Milta Power is pretty much out of reach. Mm-hmm. Where are they going to go next? I'm just really looking at their drop point here. We do see BTR and Ned Luxy. They are going towards military base. This is they're probably going to meet each other there.
Probably, because they need to find a vehicle. That's the first thing. I think they're still going to drop wherever they were before, like Milta Power for Papa R, right? They will drop once. The moment they drop, they will find a vehicle if they manage to find one. But question is, how can you drop without bumping any team so soon?
It's tough. Honestly, it's really, really tough. And I think some teams are still trying to drop. Pochinki might be contested here. Bapa is relatively near it. I'm not so sure if they want to go within. Dingo's already at George Pol. And again, Razok is just completely... There's just so many teams that I literally couldn't even see any of the names.
Yeah, they're so clumped up. But school is actually occupied by Team Tara here. But there's another team nearby. I think it's H2O.
Not to mention that there are a couple of kills already secured by RSG onto Trader there. Not exactly the best start. Tara does see the drops coming in from H2A. It takes a number of shots with the M16. However, with the iron sights, it's a little hard to hit.
Yeah, H2O will definitely leave the compound there. They have nothing on themselves right now. They just got down. It's a good thing that they had a vehicle there. Without that vehicle, I'll be a bit worried for them.
Well, this is surprising. iShot suddenly take a cover. Why is this happening? Because it doesn't seem to me there's anybody competing them in this compound right now. iShot with 3,800 total damage there, 16 total kills. Can I say that most of the kills are actually last hit kill still?
Maybe. I'm not entirely sure. I think we have to look at ESG for that one. But I'm surprised that his total headshots is only 4, because the ones that we have witnessed, those headshots are pretty ridiculous.
That's why I say, is it a kill still headshot?
No. Because remember that one at Miramar? The guy peeked, bam, right in the face with the car.
Straight in the eye one. Mm-hmm. It was crazy. But then into Rosshawk, it's kind of crowded now.
Yes, absolutely crowded. We do see here Divinity Esports against Axis. They have an invisible line against them. Oman managed to get the shot. Oh, so close. And if I'm not mistaken, if I remember correctly, during the warm-up match, it is the same teams in the same area.
Axis and Divinity? Oh, okay. In Rozok. That's a pretty good note to keep be aware of, because Erangel seems to be, you know, the map everyone needs to know how to play, but especially between these two groups, continuously having to deal with your rivals, the adaptation required is going to be a little bit more tough, because again, groups A and B have one particular style of play, B and C their own different types of play. So if you are
and
that
then
B group,
another A and C.
Exactly. So if you're in group B, you have to be ready for both A and C. So it's like, man, it's tough.
So you have to read so many teams a playstyle that is so you won't drop into their territory, or you can opt out to just go for truce and kind of mark that respective territory by your own, you know.
Do you think these teams actually go for a truce? I feel like it's super
dependent. They actually did, depend on last game where the
circle. Yeah, that took me way too long to get.
Okay, never mind. Okay, back to the game. Axis is still loitering around the corner while Divinity is still looking behind their backs, so breathing behind their backs, making sure that they're keeping tabs on them. But I think they need to move because their loot doesn't seem very decent.
Yeah, they definitely need to move. Now moving onto another location, FV as well as another team right across them. But this is a bigger location as compared to the earlier location where Divinity was. They have a lot of loot here that they can go for. And we do see here team captain for FV Unbeatable Gaming, Grim, here with 2,500 8-ish total damage, 9 kills. He's actually doing a lot of damage here just for 9 kills.
Quite true. Maybe he's a fragger there. And sometimes, you know, being the captain, you have to call the shot. So sometimes you have to call the shot so soon that your team kind of have a little bit delay of response there, because your hands, these guys, they are pro players. Your hands talk first than your mouth.
Yeah, and sometimes you don't have that time. You can't take that 0.5 of a second to give the information over. It looks like Traitor and Team No Recall are in a bit of a scuffle here, but, you know, looking over at Resurgence for now before we change back into the action. Let's see how this goes now. Ooh, Traitor Olaf quickly goes prone to protect himself, luckily, but Sin B is spotted out.
Oh no, if I'm not mistaken, they were just on the left side, and now we do see Stewart. He may just go in to wipe them out. Stewart from long range shot cannot connect his shot onto Olaf. Olaf is still proning there, but oh, cooking up the grenade. 3, 2, 1, and kaboomy at any time now. And then the grenade will go out there. Looks like that grenade connects a little bit, but the second one, not too clean. Third one goes out. Will it connect enough? I don't think so. The smoke will be there, and looks like Stewart will defend his location.
Ooh. Yeah, he needs to get out, because one nade toss back at him, he will straight away be a box there, because there's no way for him to actually get out from that compound easily. Look at how Traitor kind of cornered him every corner possible. But then Traitor, they got one, because Lu Yu is just outside of it and coming up from the front here. Stewart just ran away with a vehicle.
Mm-hmm. Yep, he did get the initial knockdown. He's not going to secure the kill, but now Axis versus Divinity. We finally get to see who concludes and becomes the Kings of Rizok for now. Again, Juggernaut having a very high position of Overwatch, keeping Axis within the buildings, making it difficult for them to kind of peek for now to get impact, but they need to deal with this Overwatch or at least some covering fire so they can start pushing over.
Oh, it's going to be hard for Trixie right now. Don't think they can go for the savior. It's almost impossible because they have Trixie as their hostage. This may be the time where Juggernaut and also Impact, they may just want to leave these compounds. Not looking good for them. Definitely Axis have managed to stamp their feet here.
Yeah, at the same time, Juggernaut is really out in the open with no helmet, clipped vest, and now nothing else than just what he has. For the rest of the team are kind of on foot. They are being denied their dominance over Rosshawk, while the rest of Team Traitor just now were fought against Team No Recall. Oh, they quite early on straight away lost some members. Casualties not great when you just drop into the map, you know.
But let's look at Axis's stats right now. Total 19 kills, which is still pretty impressive. 3k worth of damage, plenty of headshots as well, but so far they haven't been able to get that chicken dinner.
Yep. If only you can get one. But it's like you said, some teams are like hot and cold. Right? The same goes for Axis, right?
Yeah, that's right. Lots of kills there, but no chicken. Okay, I feel a little bit for him. But now moving over to Miss Rose Esports. Looks like JoJo is being the scout for them. They are moving in line, and they managed to secure one vehicle each. So that's very, very good for them. And Team Secret right now, they're just looting in the small areas. They have moved on from Pachinki.
Oh, well, they got Pachinki's loot overall. I don't think they want to stay that long anymore. But now they're going to migrate into the circle, trying to go as fast as they can into the center of it. But they're gonna hold to this compound for now. Team No Recall, on the other hand, got some casualties. There are two of them already out in the lobby quite early on. I think they have to stay a little bit low for Team No Recall, because it happens to pass by is Team Net just right in front of them.
Yeah, and once again, you know, Bigatron once going actually for a very, very greedy play. They decided to go for both sides of military base and as well as Novo. Looking at Bapa coming out of Malta Power as well as H2O coming out of Lipovka.
Oh, well, I'm surprised actually Rose Esports Syndicate didn't come up from Savini. They changed their spot again. Or they did actually drop by Savini. So that's why they're kind of in the middle of a circle. But what happened to the rest of the team? I don't see that much of their team right now. Maybe they stack up and we can just see one person.
Yeah, Rosalk seems to be right in the smack in the middle. So, Sir Claude, what exactly is going on here, especially when it comes to gatekeeping as well?
Yep, looks like we can see here on the right side of the map and on the left side of the map, some gatekeeping is going to happen. But I also must point out that Bapa are
tanking the blue, right?
Tanking the blue. It was almost impossible for them to drop at that location. Looks like they still went all the way for it. And here we do see here, ladies and gentlemen, airdrop M249 up for grabs here. Bigger looks like closest. There's one team that they could get it if they want to.
Is Bigatron marching in? Yeah, it's a big win for them, but how can they actually hold it on? But Divinity, on the other hand, kind of have to bump into none other than Matoy, who is just solo scouting the area, just a bit outside of Rosehawk. He actually jumped out of the window and now trying to hide in front. Maybe he just had the wrong day. Oh, that run! Wrong last decision making, but make it a return comeback. He managed to clutch it! He managed to clutch it! Matoy needs to recall! Oh my god! The rest of the team just managed to come on point right on time. And Matoy almost got knocked down. He was reloading. He looked at the wrong angle for a moment. Still managed to clutch one versus two against that.
How did he do it? He got the initial headshot on the first one, and he was also using an M16 that only has burst fire and single fire. That's pretty difficult to do overall.
That's Matoy. His
madness. What?
I'm like speechless here. That clutch play, that is some play there from Matoy indeed.
And how common it is that he actually, you know, he was looking the wrong direction, and one more clip and he's dead.
Absolutely. Well, Matoy, you deserve a praise there. Now moving on to these two teams here, locked down in the same location, NET as well as Axis Esports. Now they do know each other at the same location, and we do see here NET, they have the high ground upper hand. They do have vehicles as well, so they have two things that they can do. They can either look down from the top and try to clip Axis there, or they can get out of here. They're in a good spot.
Yeah, they have to control their flanks here. I think that's what NET needs to do. Because Axis, you know, is very likely to look to push. And again, the grenades are coming out just to deny. It's like, all right, if you try to push, you're going to get hit by a grenade. Now, they could look to rush in. It's a pretty risky call, but preferably I would have liked to see NET kind of spread out a little bit. Yes, just like this, to cover their left and right angles. Because look at their line of sights coming in from Axis. It's really, really difficult. They're looking up the hill, and even when they're in structures, it really narrows down where they can peek.
Yeah, the only thing that Axis can do right now is either retreat or just fan out a little bit more, making sure they confuse NET next. Because even though, yeah, they have a kind of spread out formation for NET, but it's not segregated enough because they stay in pairs 2x2. But now they're trying to get the tunneling on NET's team, which is kind of hard based on this terrain itself.
Mm-hmm. Yep, they're trying to surround them, but then again, I'm not sure if they really want to go for it.
Oh, that circle.
Just unkind. A couple of teams will need to pass by the Death Bridge, and we do see here Team Secret. Actually, it's very near one of those bridges. Dingoes, will you pass by there and eventually bump into Team Secret? But looks like Team Secret, one of them is moving away, and now we switch over to Papa R Esports.
They were tanking the blue before, but now they're happily inside of the circle. Seems like the circle god really favors them.
Yeah, especially since, you know, Bigatron as well doing the exact same thing. After, you know, getting greedy and going for both Military Base and Novo, they start rotating into the map. But let's look at some stats here. 24 kills, 4.2k damage. Wow!
The highest we've seen so far is still Yuhai, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's almost 7k, 6.8, but there, look at that spray. Beautiful one with a holoscope. Samzy managed to secure one, but can he secure more from Team Secret? Matoy was actually just the scout, the rest of them actually behind him quite far.
Yep, but Samzy releasing those shots, keeping the position, but Fata comes into a wrong place at the wrong time. Oh, Fata almost dropping into the river, and now the rest of Miss Rose Esports comes in. They need to give a lot of cover to Fata at this point, but Yuhai has eyes on Miss Rose Esports. They try to get away, get to safety, but looks like left and right, Yuhai releasing those shots, and Axis will need to find cover.
Oh no, Yuhai actually gets knocked down. This is bad. Pew Pew quickly going for the revive. He knows that they are running outside of him. They have to secure this area, making sure that this is not looking too good as the rest of Axis goes in for a full-on rush into the building. And they've got a couple of knockdowns. However, they're still looking to clear this second floor.
The rest of Team Secret right now kind of hard to play with, but Axis, why he doesn't have any mannequin on him? This is hard, and look at that! You're trying to pull the clutch! There's only one left! Eye shots trying to make the kill! He's switched down to now Micro Uzi plays. Will he get the clip on Team Secret?
Oh, he better do this. He has a Micro Uzi, and now the bandage will go out onto Appy, but looks like he canceled it for a smoke there. Not definitely not. They deny that. We don't want to see one of that too soon because iShots is all alone. They do have a chance against iShots. Now, all they just need to do is just rush onto iShots. They can do it all together. iShots should, they should be able to take him on, but iShots looks like he's going out. Oh, iShots taking the pre-empty shot first. He has smoked that just to protect him inside the house. iShots just randomly poking them. Just keeping it in the house right now.
Mm-hmm, forcing it over. I think he did hear the initial someone going for the flank, maybe getting to the second floor and maybe dropping down. So he quickly plops the smoke just in case the cover is angled. He's holding up the break. He knows he's in the second floor. He drops it down. Is he actually going to get it? No, the grenade doesn't actually connect, but he quickly boosts himself up. He's playing this so well. Everybody's completely blind. Oh, no. Oh. Axis killed themselves with a nade. And now they finish off Team iShots. Man, iShots bought a lot of time, however, was not successful. Team Secret have to bow out back into the lobby.
15 placement, they just got themselves quite too soon there. Well, Axis, that was what happened with that nade just now.
I'm not entirely sure.
I thought it was iShot's nade who exploded, but apparently they kind of blow themselves up away. But Ned, on the other hand, they kind of walk out from that scenery at quite a hot one to play by, you know. Basically, I think they watched out Team Secret entirely from that compound. It's kind of hard for iShots to get out. Well, I kind of wanna ask is that why didn't he take the UAZ and just drove out?
Again, it's tough because the moment you're in a UAZ, the rest of the team, oh, we hear the vehicle, we can all focus fire a UAZ. Like, even though, like,
or just run.
Running is even worse. Honestly, running is not an option there. However, the UAZ is a potential play. However, you're just a much bigger target, even though it does have 2,000 HP. If you have three members, it can be very easily destroyed with focus fire. It's just, you know, in certain situations where you're in a UAZ and there's only one other person, there's no way they can blow it up.
Quite true.
And now we're looking at two teams right here facing off against each other with another team not too far ahead. Tone, while Esports, they need to get in here, but it's being camped out. Oh, it's not going to be easy for them. And now moving back to Net, they're still the same location as before. But let's not forget, Fata is actually still at that river bank. Can't get out of there.
How? You tell me how. There's no way. He kind of got sandwiched between so many teams. Oh. Look at the Axis is there. There's also Net. When it comes to Net, we know how bloodthirsty they are. Especially the Atai, one of the best fraggers they have in the team. And at the same time, we have another team, which is Team, if I'm not mistaken, Impunity, right just behind them. And WoW kind of there too.
This is, I'm trying to assess the situation here, but it's kind of awkward because every single side, especially on the eastern part of the circle, is just a complete war zone. Nobody can really run out in the open without getting punished here. Miss Rose is going to be the next to fall. Trader is trying to hold his position. Hawk in the river, but again, he's getting peppered. He finally goes down. That's going to be the end of the road for Trader there.
Yes, and this is still a Mexican standoff here. We do see this as the circle moves in. More teams are actually going to show up here just behind Net. There's another team actually moving it. Oh, but looks like here we do see three different teams, BTR, FV, and also Papa R. They may, oh, looks like here grenades go out from Kiddo, but nothing connects there.
Oh, they just rush in for Bigatron. There you go, kind of make a big noise there, while the rest of Papa R just running around their tails. But Kiddo on the other hand is actually tunneling them down. They got every vision they want.
Mm-hmm. And Sleep, again, the grenades are still coming in from FV, and we know that Bigatron's very good at clearing buildings. That's, you know, the one thing that's they are extremely efficient at. Papa A on the other side, they hear the push. They don't want to deal with it considering that the grenades are being lobbed over from FV. They make a call. They go into the next structure, look for a retreat to hopefully hold down the fort.
Yeah, but how far can they go? Because on the other side, there are more teams actually waiting for them. So now in this compound here, three teams locked onto each other. Everyone just taking their own buildings at this point. Oh, this is starting to be a big Mexican standoff here with Towao Esports. They need to get in, but a big chunk of land here that they need to pass through with Impurity not too far away. It's not going to be easy for them.
The question is who actually right inside of a circle. We are talking about so many teams still surviving. There's 11 teams with 40 alive. Everybody just loves the school right now, hugging as much as they can because it's still in the compound, which is inside of a circle. But Zazali just being needed straight away. Is it Kido's working just now?
I don't know. Kiddo is just trying to work his magic here, trying to secure, figure out where exactly is Bigatron. Maybe, you know, forcing them to use currency, a nade for maybe a med kit. That's not too big. That's, you know, a pretty big deal considering that the last few circles are coming by. However, FB trying to take a position here, but it's not working out too well as the rest of Dingoes has come to clean up shop.
Oh, Dingoes. Just coming from nowhere, from behind, and now Sam will just bop it all up. Looks like every sleep is still outside of the building. Dingoes have taken over this building. Sleep is all alone. The last team member standing. He will go in and out, but Sleep is taking damage. His shot just hit the wall. Oh, it's going to be really difficult. Even if he can run away, oh, he'll be spotted out. This is going to be bad, bad news.
And now just around the corner, Dingoes trying to finish it off. And there you go, Sleep. He's now sleeping with the rest of the team. Placed himself at 11th place. Back into the game. Resurgence is going out for WoW. But at the same time, they have Bigatron on the side. There's also no recall. Silently being a peeping ball, a peeping Tom there, making sure they're stalking every movement possible just around him.
Big grenade coming in. Dingoes takes quite a bit of damage. But unfortunately, realizes it too late. But Bigatron 2 is still part of this. And they are making sure that Dingoes don't get out of this alive. GG is just so far away. He can't really do too much. And he doesn't have an angle because of the structure protecting Bigatron. This is not looking too good.
Oh, Tara is also nearby. They are in the middle. They're setting that fight out. But then again, if anyone comes towards the side of Tara, they can easily snipe them out from that angle. We do see here Bapa are having their own building, trying to defend this location. Oh, everyone's locked down. But it will not be for long before they're forced to actually move.
Yep, they were forced to move in a couple of seconds now. Look at that. The circle are already shrinking more, but the rest of net is still trying to just hold this compound. They are playing the levels, different levels here, because we know Papa and net kind of share the same vicinity and the probably the same building even, but Tara on the other hand might just take this an advantage.
Yeah, it's going to be tough. 10 teams left coming into the fifth phase of the game. Net, on the other hand, trying to hold their own structure, but this is not easy. It's way too close in proximity. Axis get another nade. Oh boy, this is a game for sure.
It's Appy once more, twice in a row. If he's playing, then he's really having a good time. I can swear to God, we can see his fit there, blowing himself out twice. But now back to the game. WoW out in the open. There's also Impunity from the bottom of the map just now. Net, on the other hand, kind of sharing the same building with Papa Abba, still going for Impunity, giving a lot of pressure from the outside.
RSG looks like they are moving into the middle of the circle with a couple of vehicles there. They want to secure themselves those spots. It is now down to the top 10 teams, ladies and gentlemen. Whatever that we see on the structure right now, those structures on the right side of the map, expect that once the circle closes in, everyone will evacuate everything. But oh, looks like RSG's in trouble now. Iron Pro has been knocked down, and looks like bloodbath is happening here.
They're gonna continue on. Bapa holding on to the second top of the structure for now, making Overwatch as soon as possible. However, the rest of the teams, this is going to be a bloodbath very, very quickly. 10 teams on phase 6 is a little too many. The numbers need to dwindle down as Bapa trying to snipe out WoW on the north side of the map. However, that isn't the only issue that they have to worry about, as the south side and the western side of their building is completely filled with enemies. Axis getting a good kill onto Axis there from Bapa Bard.
And Axis, they march themselves in the safe zone, but always being clipped and denied entirely their movement. But Bard, on the other hand, just being a nuisance. Look at that, he tossed every utility he has and will block their way out. There's another nade being thrown out at Tara, who's been cornered every way possible. The rest of the teams are so segregated. They are forced to get into one vehicle, making sure that he survived by the end of the day.
And looks like Jenny, he has eyes on all the opponents. Oh, what happened there? Oh, close quarters. Wow. Where did that come from? Kevin coming out of nowhere. But then again, there's more to come. Kevin will need to continue the fight. Oh. And Kevin will be knocked down. His team needs to save him, but I don't think so. His team is all too far away. Boyka and the rest of the team members. Zali is the closest one. Zali with no clutch play there from Zali. He drives the only one left in the same building. He will just need to turn this around for his team.
Surprise, mother, father, at that. Look at that straight in the face. And now this will go for just rushing in. Now they are taking as a third party, wiping everything possible. This is just a disastrous moment for Nen. And now, even though they got a small victory, but nah, Papa are just going to be Papa, destroy everyone.
Yeah, and even though Boyka was trying to make a run for it, RSG noticed somebody was running across the map and nobody gets to walk in the open for free. Take him out. Resurgence coming into the last couple of circles. They have not been, they've been avoiding these structures for a long, long time. And I think this time it's really, really beneficial. Hydra coming in from BTR. Last member, he's trying to breathe. He's holding his gun. He's like, ah, oh, this is really, really bad. Papa is in the next room. I need to take four people out. However, he has, six. That's unfortunate.
That's really unfortunate. But what's fortunate is for RSG at this moment, except for Voki, he seems to be in trouble now. Loyu is actually at that small house at the end. He has side on Voki and team. Now RSG cannot easily go and save Voki. They will need to put the smokes out and weld. 10 more seconds until everything breaks loose again.
And just now, Voki was trying to hop into the car, but now look at that Papa. They try to run, but Hydra just make it difficult for everybody else. If you're not going, we're not going, then everybody stays. That's what they're saying. And the rest of Papa have to actually fall back a little bit because one of their teammates really in the need of revive.
Mm-hmm. And they are punishing them for not clearing it out. Now, Papa, I have given up the structure. Hydra is punishing them from the back. No recoil is finally down, but Papa are controlling the center for now with two stragglers from WoW and one straggler from Hydra. They want to punish him as much as possible. Hydra is making a run for the smoke, using that line of sight, covering himself, making sure he can't be shot just yet. Small boy needs to take advantage, and yes, he does. Hydra from Bigatron is down, and that means Bigatron is back into the lobby.
Brilliant play indeed. He just needs to peek and manage to get the kill off. That is really, really good. RSG, this location is where you want to be. They are right smack in the middle of the circle. You don't want to be at the side of... Oh! Hi-Hi here being taken out by six. Panda is the only one left for Tone Wild Esports, while Papa R has 14 members left.
Yeah, Panda is the mouse in between two elephants, and there you go. Finish off by six, and down to two teams. 4 versus 4 for Papa against Resurgence, who's doing A-OK, but knock one down for Y2K, and the rest of it still trying to get the position right.
Mm-hmm. Yes, they are. The smokes can only protect them from so long. They have a bit of structure as Papa trying to push on through. They have level 3 body armor, but a lot of their armor is hurt already. Micro Uzi knocking down 6 here, who had broken armor. Another one going down onto Trixie. Now, Jenny trying to revive Bart. The last two members is Resurgence. Go in for the big kill! The push on the right-hand side has been taken down, quickly switching over to the left. Jenny is making sure that they can win this game if we can get this revive off.
And now left, Iron Bro and Voki right now, only two of the left. They are clumping out each other. Small boy is now in a good position. And now Papa R, they will go for the revive, and now they will try to reset themselves. But Trixie cannot be revived. But looks like he's very, very low at this moment. Jenny will try to flag this from one side, and now the grenades go up from Voki, trying to buy time for Small Boy and let them try to revive him, but it's going to be really, really difficult.
And Jenny just now kind of got a little bit lopsided from the nade, but there we go, he got straight in the line of sight for Jenny. Still didn't manage to knock them down. Iron Bro on the other hand trying to get it. Oh, this is just not easy to play with.
Resurgence, can they pull this off? It's a 1v2 situation here. Papa have held on to their own, and Voki getting trying to help Small Boy out, inevitably got himself knocked down. However, that smoke is going to protect Voki for now to kind of run across. I'm not entirely sure why Small Boy didn't decide to join him as well, but they will get the revive, putting it into a 2v2 situation as Jenny, he's trying to push on over. They do it! Well done to Papa as they push on through. They tried really, really hard there, and they finally get that chicken dinner.
So close for Resurgence. They were actually at a 50-50% situation to get themselves that chicken dinner. It was 4 versus 4 at first.
Great shots. Great shots coming up.
Great shots. RSG, they had a very good position in first. They had a small structure there. They had a couple of trees, a couple of bushes. They were in the circle, but then again, Papa, come on. They had the guts to just go in and finish it off towards the end. Excellent play indeed.
6 minutes to clip them up was a little bit more. So that was a big move.